We promised to set up a good government. The government, of course, will be based on the constitution and the law of this country. We are particularly keen to ensure that the constitution is upheld and that the laws of the country is what will guide us through our administration. Policy-wise, I think the business people should be assured, because as you may know, although now some people have forgotten about it and claim that it is the policy of the government that has just been defeated. Actually, the idea of a business-friendly government was mooted long ago when we introduced the concept of Malaysia Incorporated. We intend to build up Malaysia's economy with the help of investors from inside and outside the country. We would like to see a very active stock market and also increase in capitalisation of the stock market. We think we can achieve this because we have people who are experienced in the economic field and also finance. There should be no cause for any devaluation of the ringgit. As you know, we cannot revalue the ringgit too much, or else will not be competitive. But we will try to make the ringgit as steady as possible. We will also not have this petrol price adjusted every few seconds. Now we think that we can do quite a bit there, because we know where the money is, and I think we can squeeze some people who have the money. But also some of the debts, I think, were too big for us. So we need to renegotiate the terms and the amount. And of course, the terms of payment over the years. The interest rate sometimes is too high. That also will look good. So as you can see, there is a lot of things that we can do to mitigate the situation. For the Malaysian finance. We believe that we can get most one MDB money back, because we know you have the money in America, in Singapore, in Switzerland, in probably in Johor and in